You are currently located inside the Vertical Assembly Center at NASA's Michoud Assembly Facility. You are suspended beside the robotic weld tool that manufactured major structures that will make up the massive core stage for Exploration Mission 1, the first flight of the Space Launch System and Orion spacecraft. This is the Space Launch System intertank structural test article. The intertank has been loaded on a space transporter designed to move the large pieces of the core stage. The intertank fits between the liquid hydrogen tank and liquid oxygen tank and is the only piece of the core stage that is made by bolting pieces together rather than welding. To make big rockets, you need a big space. The Michoud Rocket Factory could hold 31 football fields. Seen here are a few of the robotic weld tools in the facility used to make domes and barrels for SLS. Domes for the second flight of SLS have been built. These domes form the ends of the large tanks that hold more than 700,000 gallons of propellant for the four RS-25 engines. Here, the intertank flight hardware is being outfitted with thousands of avionics wires and cables, which are the brains of the rocket. If you look behind you, you can see the tank that will hold the liquid oxygen. These two pieces of hardware will be joined with the forward skirt to form the top half of the 212-foot-long core stage. NASA's barge Pegasus comes in handy when moving all the large hardware for testing and flight. The barge was lengthened and strengthened to be able to move the SLS core stage, the largest rocket stage NASA has ever built. From the control room at the front of the barge, the crew can look ahead and still keep an eye on the hardware through the door behind you. The intertank was loaded onto Pegasus and is now at Marshall Space Flight Center in Huntsville, Alabama, where it is undergoing tests to ensure it can survive the harsh environments during launch and ascent.